solemn day. Thank you, photojournalist Drew McAllister, for that. We are watching WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar. No alerts for us. And we're going to show you that some parishes have just been taken out of the severe thunderstorm watch that goes until 7. Strongest storm still over the North Shore at this time. You can see the movement has generally been east within that line of storms. There's southwest northeast movement. Picky and get the heavier downpours at this time. Get Mandeville to Covington. We got some heavier downpours, but look at the weakening trend that's there. So I'm going to actually take the movement off for you so we can just see where we are at the current time. Now we're watching this outflow boundary right here, this kind of miniature cold front, developing the chance that we could get some showers and storms right over the heat of the city. So there's that line, and again, it's almost essentially a cold front here for us. We do still see that we've got some broken storms that are still farther west of even Thibodaux to Houma here. Let's go in and show you where we've got this little bit of downpour activity right on our parish borders, and you can see in some pretty rural areas, but Chack Bay, maybe some heavier downpours to South Vachery and Vachery here, getting some heavier rain. So that's about the rain we've got right now, but to speak of what we've got for at least that watch that's in effect. Severe thunderstorm watch is now only effective for parts of St. Tammany, Pearl River, and Hancock counties into Mississippi. We're going to see it on this end too, where it's the risk of really strong winds. There is the chance that the Storm Prediction Center maybe set a tornado or two, but I'm really not concerned. Temperatures here this morning, mild and muggy, or at least warm and muggy. We were at 78. We topped out at 92. I think that's the hottest we've done so far this year. I think that's the highest we've gone officially, 92. We've got real-time temperatures still at 90 degrees with the high humidity in place. This is feeling well over 100. It is feeling really hot outside. At least we've got some rain cooled air in some of those areas to the North Shore. A little bit of a breeze today, too. South and southwest winds around 10 to 15 and some higher gusts. So we're in this pattern where we're kind of at the peak and end of the peak of severe season into the Midwest. You got storms that fire up in complexes over Texas move our way. It's all about the timing and where the placement of those storms are to give us a chance of maybe overnight early morning storms and even the chance that we get the energy of developing storms during the day too. So the high risk forecast has a pretty good eye on what's going to happen the next 2 days. Let me show it to you. So right now, the short term forecast shows if we do get a storm and maybe some rain here in New Orleans, it might be more 8 to 9 o'clock, well after sunset. Could even see an overnight storm here too, just that I showed with those storms west moving our way. Mild, muggy, or even warm from low 70s to the North Shore, nearly 80 to start off in New Orleans. This is nothing new. Go to tomorrow's high-res forecast. Doesn't show a whole lot of storm activity. I've seen other high-res data that have more storms than this. I give it about a 50-50 odds, a 40% chance is where I'm going to put it tomorrow. But if we do develop a storm, we're under levels 1 and 2 risk for possible severe storms, so an impact day for sure. Hot and humid. Temperature around 90 once again. The heat index, when you factor in the humidity, going to be well over 100 to maybe 103 to maybe even 104. Wednesday's high-res forecast shows a lot more storm activity than what we got tomorrow. This is about an 80% chance of storms, and this could be a stormy day, maybe all day, and that could hold temperatures down. We're already under a risk for possible severe storms here, too, on Wednesday. Low risk, level 1 risk, but it'll still be an impact day. But I think we could be holding temperatures way down if we get the storm activity that's been projected by that high-res outlook. Humidity not going anywhere. We get from Wednesday going into Thursday, more storm activity shown to explode here, too. So we've got likely rain chances to go through the next several days as we get into maybe even Wednesday, Thursday, when it all comes to end the front on Friday. This Friday front, and we're getting fewer and fewer of these, but enjoy them while you can, drops in a nice weekend. Temperatures in the 80s, and we're going to have less humid air, too.